Hey guys, what's up? So today's video is going to be a New Year's Eve look. I created this look that you see right here. So it is very dramatic, very sparkly and glittery, and just it screams New Year's Eve to me, because for New Year's Eve, you definitely want that glamour, that sparkle, like all of that. So I am obsessed with it. I absolutely love how this look turned out. I hope you all have a wonderful New Year's. Please be sure to like and subscribe before you leave. And if you would like to see how I got this dramatic, black, glittery, smoky eye, then just keep on watching. All right, you guys, so we're gonna start off with the eyes today. So as you can see, I already have scotch tape laid down, and then I do already have on my P. Louise eye base. So we're gonna start off with the Tati Beauty Textured Neutrals Volume 1 palette, and I'm gonna take Matte Soothe on my Morphe M4. Oh, hold up. M441. I picked up the wrong brush. Let's get in focus. Okay. M441. I picked up the wrong brush when I got ready to film. So, picking that up, dusting off the excess, and we're gonna use this as our transition shade. So I'm gonna dust off that brush and then we're just gonna buff this out. Honestly, like, these shadows blend like a dream. Like, a lot of times if I start off with that much product, it's so hard to buff it away and like make a seamless blend. But like, look at that. It does it so effortlessly. Love it. Alright, so we're going to do the exact same thing on the other eye. So again, using the same brush, keeping this in this upper crease area to work as our transition shade. Alright, and then now that I have that laid down, I'm wiping off that brush and then just going in with circular motions, and we're just going to buff this out. Just like so. So now I'm gonna pick up my Morphe M433 and I'm gonna go in with the shade Matte Ritual, which is this one right here. And we're gonna take this on the outer half of the eye and then into the crease. So I'm kind of sweeping it up along that, sweeping it up against that tape, and then we're gonna bring it into the crease. I'm bringing it all the way from outer corner all the way to inner corner of this crease. So it should look something like that once you have it placed down. So then I'm going to wipe off the brush and we're going to start blending this out. So I am using windshield wiper motions first, which is a very light hand. So I keep my hand a little further down on the brush so that I don't use as much pressure. And I'm just kind of buffing over everything for now. And then I'm gonna wipe off again. And then I'm gonna go in with small circular motions right up in between the Ritual and Soothe shades to just blend those two together up here in the crease. And then I'm gonna pick up that M441 and then I just like to dust over the top of the crease and just make sure everything is nice and blended. Just like so. Alright, so now let's do that exact same thing on the other eye. So again, just kind of sweeping it from that tape. Then we're going to sweep it into the crease, all the way from outer corner all the way to inner corner. And then you should have something kind of like that after you get done wiping off that brush and just kind of dusting over everything, just making sure it's all blended out really nicely. And I am also, like, I don't really care if this gets on the lid. I actually kind of want to bring it on the lid just a little bit, just to kind of deepen it up. Just because I do want this to be a real nice smoky look, because it is New Year's Eve and you want that full glam sort of look. So if that's what you're going for. But that's what I'm going for today. So we do want that full glam, intense, black, smoky eye. So the deeper, the better. All right. Now I'm just picking up Memory Matte, which is the black shade on that same M433 from Morphe. And now we're going to do the same thing, but kind of keeping it a little bit lower. So as you can see, I'm kind of pressing that up against that tape on the outer half of the eye right out here. And then I am going to bring it in the crease, but I'm keeping it pretty low because we don't want to bring it up too high. We want the browns to be what's up high and then the black to be a little bit lower. So I've got it all stamped on like so right out here. So then I'm going to dust off that brush on this towel that I have on my lap. And now we're going to go in and blend. So I'm just going to kind of use circular motions and just kind of blend it kind of all over the place. Okay, I guess I shouldn't say all over the place because we don't want to make a mess of it. But starting on the lid, just kind of using circular motions and buffing and then bringing that into the crease. And then I'll continue to wipe off my brush in between to just ensure that like it stays nice and clean and not too messy. So that is what we are doing right now. And honestly, you guys, like the whole reason I wanted to do a black smoky eye for New Year's Eve is because I've only ever done a black smoky eye once before. And like, I mean, it was all right, but like I wasn't obsessed with it because usually black is hard to blend out when that's like your predominant color. But I will say this Tati Beauty palette, like it's so effortless. Like look at how effortlessly that blended out. Like it's insane. So this makes me feel totally okay to do a black smoky eye because it blends out like I want it to without having to work at it for 5 hours because who wants to do that? Not me. So again, just wiping off that brush, and we're gonna do small circular motions all over the lid, just buffing this all out, bringing it into the crease. Okay, so now I want to bring back a little bit of that lighter brown. So I'm going to pick up my M441 again and a little bit of that matte Sue shade, which is that first shade that we used as our transition. And then I'm just going to lightly buff over the top of this, just like so. Just like that. So now I am going to use my Morphe M421 and I'm going to pick up the metallic memory shade, which is this one right here. And I'm also going to move my mirror that I'm using just a little bit closer for myself. So I am not using any Fix Plus or anything like that. And I will say with swatching these, this metallic does feel a little different, like formula wise, than the other metallics. Like this one feels a little chunkier and you can kind of see that on the eye. Here, let me zoom in a little bit more. I feel like you can kind of see that on the eye that it is a little chunkier. Ooh, this is already dusting down on my face. Okay, you know what? I'm not loving that. I'm gonna use my finger. So I'm just using my middle finger and I'm just gonna stamp this metallic memory shade most of the way on the lid. I'm leaving this very outer part just matte, but mostly all over the lid. So now I'm going to go in with the glitter from the Memory Shade, and I'm going to use, I'm going to use my ring finger, and I'm just going to stamp this over the top of that metallic. Just like that. Sorry, I should have used my other hand. This is kind of hard to see. Okay, I went over just a teeny bit far on this side, so I'm gonna pick up my M433 and just lightly dust a little bit of that away, just right there. So this is what we're working with. So I'm now going to remove the tape. Just like that. So this is what you should have. I'm gonna clean up the under eyes and apply mascara and lashes really quick. So the lashes I'm gonna use today are the Velour Silk Lashes in Fluff and Edgy. So I'm going to go do that, and then I will be right back so that we can get started on the face. I haven't had these lashes on in a while, and I kind of forgot how much I love them. They're awesome. Okay, so we're gonna move on to the face. We're gonna use the Too Faced Hangover RX Primer. Use any primer that you know lasts really well on your skin, because it's New Year's Eve, you know, you're gonna want your makeup to last all night long. But for me, this is something that does really, really well on my skin. So this is what I'm gonna be using. And then for foundation, I'm going to use the Smashbox Studio Skin 15 Hour Wear Hydrating Foundation. And this is in the shade 2.1. So I definitely want a full coverage foundation today with how dramatic we have the eyes. And I'm just using my Morphe Highlight and Contour Sponge to buff this into the skin. This is my favorite sponge to use when I use tape on the eyes and everything, like with my eyeshadow, because with the sharp line on this, I can be really precise up against there when I do my concealer, which I love. So this is definitely my favorite sponge to use for when I'm doing dramatic makeup like this. Now let's put on some concealer. I'm using my Tarte Shape Tape. I'm mixing the shades Light Neutral and Fair Neutral. So now I'm going to use my RCMA No Color Powder. Okay. Okay. Now I'm picking up the Kat Von D Shade and Light Contour Palette. And I'm going to go in with this middle shade right there with my Morphe JH02 brush. So now I'm going to go in with this shade right here in the palette, and then I'm going to use my Morphe JH05 brush. Alright, so now for blush, I'm going to use the Tarte blush in the shade Seduce with my Morphe JH04. Just like that. So now I'm going to mix the Jaclyn Hill Mood Light powders. I'm going to mix Carrots and Doomy just for a subtle glow really quick. So let me get some out in each cap. Because it's New Year's Eve, we want a glow baby glow. So we're starting off with this one and then we will go more intense in just a little bit. I'm using my Morphe M510. And I am just taking this on the tops of the cheeks, and then I've actually really liked taking it in like the apples right in here to just add a little bit of glow, and it actually really softens the blush and everything too. So I have been loving doing that. Oh, I forgot a step. Alright, I'm gonna use this brush. So I like to add just a little bit of, I don't want to say contour because I'm not really good at contouring my nose, but a little bit of like bronze to my nose. So I'm going to mix the bronzer shade and then the contour shade that I used. And this is just the brush that came in the Lunar Beauty palette, like the Life's a Drag. I shouldn't just say Lunar Beauty palette. And I'm just going to lightly bronze up the side. Or sides, not side, of my nose. Just give a little bit of color to the nose so it's not left out or anything like that. Now that I have that done and I have a little bit of color to my nose, I'm going to go back in with those Mood Light powders, and I like to take just a little bit and sweep it along the bridge of the nose because I'm oily and this gives just enough glow to add some nice shape to the nose with doing that bronzer and everything, but without it being overdone. Okay, so for the next step, I'm going to take the shade Extra in the Beaming Light highlighters, and I'm going to kind of push my brows up. So I found a way that I really like this brush from Jaclyn Hill Cosmetics. It's the JH03. I did not like it on the face, but I actually really, really like it for this. But I only like to do it if I do not have my eyebrows on yet, and I do not right now, clearly. So I'm putting a little bit of that on the brush, and then I just take it, woo, and kind of sweep it under the brow bone like that. I don't know. I really like how it applies it underneath the brows, but like I said, you cannot do it if, I mean, you could, but I don't like to do it if I already have my brows on, because then I think it gets in the eyebrows and I'm not really a fan of it. But so now for highlights, I'm going to take the beaming highlights. I'm going to take the shade Amped. So now what I like to do with these is I like to mist my face first. So I'm going to take my Morphe Continuous Setting Mist and I'm going to spritz my face. Let that dry just a little bit. Okay, and then I'm going to top off the cheekbones with Amped. I think this Amped shade might seriously be my favorite shade out of all of them. But now I'm going to take Extra, which is that shade that I used underneath my eyebrow, and we're just going to boop just a little bit or light on the high point right there. I love it. I think it just takes it to the next level. Obsessed. All right, you guys, I'm gonna zoom you back in and we are gonna finish off the eyes. So, all right, so jumping back in to the Tati Beauty palette, we are gonna take, hold on, let me get it open. Okay. All right, so I'm gonna take my Morphe JH39 brush. So what is this? Yeah, 39. And I'm gonna take Matte Soothe, which is that one right there. And I'm, let me move my mirror closer too. Hot Mess Express. Okay, so I am just going to take that Matte Soothe and we're going to dust it all along the lower lash line. Now, I actually do not want the lower lash line to be too smoky for this look, so we're going to keep it, so we're keeping it just a little more understated for the under eyes. And don't get me wrong, I still want the under eyes to look good. We don't want to forget about them, but we want to keep the attention on the upper lid. So now I'm taking my Morphe E36 and I'm going to take Matte Ritual. And I'm just taking this really on like the outer half and just lightly dragging it in. Okay, and then for just a teeny tiny bit of smokiness, I'm gonna take my Morphe M432 and I'm gonna take the Matte Memory shade. And we're gonna do this like right up against the lashes right here, just on this outer third, and then just lightly drag it down. And then I'll pick up that E36 that I did with the Ritual shade and just buff that out. So now I just grabbed my Morphe JH42 brush and I'm going to go back in with that extra highlighter from Jaclyn Cosmetics and just highlight the inner corners. Alright, so I'm I'm going to put on my eyebrows off camera and put some lower lash mascara on, and I will be right back. Alright you guys, brows are on, lower lash mascara is on, so now I'm just going to apply some lipstick. I'm going to use the Jeffree Star liquid lipstick in the shade Mannequin. Alright you guys, that is it for this makeup look. I hope you all enjoyed. Have a very happy New Year's, and I hope 2020 is a good year for all of you. Thank you all so much for watching. Bye!